Approximately 3.7 million years ago, the largest marine predator that ever existed roamed the oceans. Known as the Megalodon Shark, individuals were truly massive with lengths exceeding 58 feet and weights exceeding 100,000 pounds. These apex predators had unusually large sharp teeth, 7 inches or 17.5 centimeters long, such as this fossilized specimen I am holding. However, within 100,000 years, this shark species would be extinct. During the next 1 million years, a number of similar extinctions occurred along marine megafauna, largely due to the slow decrease in temperature around the planet. Then, 2.5 million years ago, 36% of marine megafauna, along with a number of species on land, suddenly went extinct. The cause of this small-scale mass extinction was the beginning of the planet's most recent ice age, which was likely triggered by a large asteroid impact. This asteroid impact occurred off the coast of Chile in the deep ocean, creating megatsunamis which raced around the planet. The deposits from these megatsunamis have been widely since found along the western coast of South America. So, how did a large asteroid impact trigger the planet's latest ice age along with a mass extinction? This video will answer this question and discuss the Eltanin impact crater. The Eltanin impact crater is located far off the coast of southern Chile, where it is 1,370 kilometers west-southwest of the city of Punta Arenas. Although difficult to see due to the low resolution of ocean topography in the area, a 35-kilometer-wide circular depression can be spotted with a large central peak typical of complex impact craters. It originated approximately 2.51 million years ago when the Earth was already experiencing a long-term cooling trend. At the time, a 3-kilometer or 1.9-mile-wide asteroid was on a collision course with Earth. This asteroid had an unusual composition containing large brickyated fragments with equal parts metallic nickel iron and silicate minerals. Known as a mesosiderite, it originated due to an ancient massive collision of the asteroid belt asteroid Vesta when a large impacting body ejected material ranging from the crust to its core. These pieces later resolidified together, forming a family of rare meteorites. As the asteroid entered the upper atmosphere, it was traveling at a speed of 20 kilometers per second or 45,000 miles per hour. Animals who lived on the planet at the time, including llamas, may have looked upwards and seen a bright streak of light travel across the sky. Moments later, an explosion equivalent in energy to the detonation of 3 million megatons of TNT occurred as the asteroid struck a 4,900-meter-deep section of the ocean floor. This powerful explosion pulverized a large section of water and crust over a vast area, generating a magnitude 8.5 earthquake. Simultaneously, a powerful shockwave was generated, causing limbs to rip off of trees at 1,400 kilometers distant on the western coast of Chile. Due to the vast amount of water which was ejected high into the air, a temporary 1-kilometer-tall tsunami near the impact site was generated. This tsunami wave would dissipate over time, but would cause 200-meter-high waves to strike the western and southern coasts of South America alongside the Antarctic Peninsula. 8 hours later, a 60-meter-high wave reached the eastern coast of New Zealand. After another 2 hours, 35-meter-high waves reached the southern coast of Mexico and Australia. While the impact of the tsunami was extreme, it was not the direct cause of the subsequent mass extinction. Rather, the impact caused a temporary impact winter as large volumes of dust and rock were thrown high into the air, causing a severely decreased amount of sunlight to reach the ground. During this brief period, large ice caps and snow cover quickly expanded across extreme northern and southern latitudes. When the effects of the impact winter faded, the cooling remained as these glaciers now reflected large amounts of sunlight into space. This decreased Earth's average temperature, creating a feedback loop which triggered the planet's most recent ice age. Many species were unable to survive this sudden change, causing widespread extinctions. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Adam Gatewood, for supporting this channel.